Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Yeah, today is a special day. I have two announcements I'm very excited to tell you about. Yeah, but as you can see, there's a lot of flies out here. It's not mosquitoes, but flies. So I think I'll light my fire and cook my little meal. And then I'll tell you about these two things when I'm drinking my coffee. And this is beef. Yeah. I'm going to make a stew, a Viking stew. And one thing the Vikings ate a lot was this cabbage, I think it's called. And yeah, it's very healthy and tastes good. Just going to make a little portion. Only for me, one meal, so I think this is enough. And I can feel the flies are not so annoying anymore because of the fire here and the smoke. It's been raining for many days, so everything is wet. It's hard to keep this fire going, but and that's why it smokes so much. Almost done now, so just a couple of minutes and I can begin my stew. Yeah. Now the bread is finished and yeah, I can put over the stew. A little bit of onions in. Yeah. And some garlic. Yep. Then some water. And of course salt. Everyone and welcome.
Now it's cooking.
Yeah, and while my food are cooking, I would like to tell you about my first announcement. As the title indicates, it's time. That means it's time for two different things. And the first is, as you probably have noticed, I will not change my name from Cimbrer Bushcraft to other, but I'll add something, and that is Viking Heritage. And that is because I'm going more and more in that direction, making Viking stuff, and I think it's a good title so people can see what it is that I'm doing. I'll still make some bushcraft videos, but my main videos will be like this in surroundings and with my Viking gear. So, and therefore I also have made a new logo, or have had some help for it. When I announced it on my video that I'm going to make a new logo, I asked for help, and a lot of friendly subscribers and other people were offering their help. It ended up that I made a collaboration with a guy called Volkan Turan. His name is Satis on his Instagram page, and I put a link to all his pages, some Facebook too. And he's a graphic designer. He says he's a sales and digital marketing consultant. And he helped me create this logo, and I'm very pleased with it. It was a long process. We tried many things, but finally this logo, I think it's cool. So I want to use that in the future, and you can already see it on my YouTube account, and hopefully also on my Instagram and otherwhere. So this is my new thing, and I'm very excited for this, and I think it's a good solution for me. Some of you are not keen on my Viking stuff videos, and others like them, and some like my Cimbrer camp, and now I showed you I can make a Viking overnighter there, and I'll probably do that again, perhaps together with Martin. So I think I have a lot of opportunities. I very much like the Viking stuff, and I'm reading a lot about it, and knowing more and more for every day. So I'll bring that into my videos, tell you about the Viking Age and how I look at it, and all the findings that I've got. As you can see, the flies are very annoying now. And I think my food are almost ready. Let's see. Well, it's cooking. Yeah. So when I've finished my food and ate my stew with my bread, I will talk about the other announcement I have, and that is something that I've been very excited for many weeks now. So, hope you like. Now I think it's finished. Just heat this bread. Yeah.
now it's finally boiling. Let it boil for a minute or so. And then let it grist.
Yeah, and now for my second announcement, and well, I think it's the most important. Maybe you have noticed, but I finally got my Seax. Yeah, I found a blacksmith, actually in Canada, who wanted to make this, and we talked about it, and he made some samples that we discussed over the internet, and we came up with this result. I'm very pleased with it. It's exactly how I want it to be, and I'm so happy I find a blacksmith that thinking like me. Yeah, I'll take you a little bit closer so you can see, and I'll tell you about the specific the information about this wonderful Seax. Yeah, and this Seax, Cimbrer Seax, it's 28.5 centimeters long, about 11.2 inches. The blade is 16 centimeters, 6.2 inches, and the handle 12.5 centimeter, 5 inches. The blade thickness will be 4.7 millimeters, 3/16, or 0.19 in thickness. Yeah. The steel for this Seax is the 80 CRV2. It's high carbon steel, and the maker said it's a very good steel for this kind of knife. It's Scandi grind. The handle is made of buckcoot, or buckcoat. It's very durable and rough looking wood. It's a tree species that comes from Central America. The price, including the sheets, will be $175 plus shipping. And the name of this awesome blacksmith is called Rob Gadois. Sorry if I pronounced it wrong. I think it's French. He has a company called Southpaw Forge, and he's been a blacksmith in Ontario, Canada for more than 7 years. He makes custom ironworks pieces such as fire pokers, cook sets, tools and decorative pieces, as well as knives and leatherworks. A knife is his most requested items. And if people want to get in contact with him for buy my Cimbrer Seax. I put a link in my video description for his Instagram page, Rob Gabois, and his Facebook page, Southpaw Forge. And of course his email address, so you can contact him that way. I'm so glad and so pleased and so grateful for have this opportunity to make a collaboration with him. I got other blacksmith that I have talked to, but well, Rob and I had from the beginning we look at it the same way, and I'm very grateful that we came up with this result. It's durable and very tough, and it's primitive looking. I like that, and the sheet is also very simple. We agreed to that, and yeah, there's not much decoration on it because we have to get the price as low as possible, and this price, $175, is the price that he can make it for you, so you can afford to buy it.
Yeah, as I said before, to keep the price down, it's very simple sheath, and it comes with these rivets, so yeah, to hold this belt loop. But I made this, I think it look cool, and you can make those yourself if you want to. I'm also considering burning something in here, perhaps my name, Cimbrer Seax. But yeah, it's a wonderful sheath for it, and I love it.
Rob is a very friendly guy, and I appreciate my collaboration with him, and I'm sure he'll take good care of you if you order one of my Cimbrer Seax. I don't get any money out of this deal, mainly because to have the price as low as possible, I don't get any revenue of this, and that's okay for me. My prime goal is to make a knife or a Seax that I think is cool. I haven't seen a Seax like this, that small, and you can use it as a bushcraft knife, whatever you want. It's simple and it's cool looking, and yeah, I just love the looks of it. Yeah, and I hope you like it too. So go in, look at his Instagram page. There's a lot of pictures from other knives he's made there, but mainly my Cimbrer Seax. I would like you to look at that and perhaps consider buying one. Yeah, that means a lot to me. It's been an okay day out here in the Little White Bog. Unfortunately, the firewood was not completely dry, so I had a little struggle keeping it alive. But I did manage to get my food prepared and my coffee. So this is the most important thing here. Yeah, folks, this is all for now. I hope you enjoyed this little video and my two announcements, my new name and my new logo, a new design on my YouTube channel. Also, of course, my new Seax, my Cimbrer Seax. I hope you like that and perhaps considering buying that. Yeah. Then I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye. Take care. Skål, everyone. Mm-hmm.